Hello everyone, this is Sage and welcome to the Executive Corner by Calkine TV. And in today's show we have Mr. Stephen Yatomi Clarke, the CEO and Managing Director of Prescient Therapeutics. We bring you the industry leaders, successful business owners, market and equity advocates all under the one roof to help you discover the insights of the stock markets and of course help you understand how you can create multiple passive income streams. So in today's show, like I said, we have Mr. Stephen Yatomi Clarke, who is the CEO and Managing Director of Prescient Therapeutics. Now, to give you some background, Prescient Therapeutics is involved in the universal CAR T and targeted therapies that are both personalized medicine approaches that seek to improve patient outcomes and provide new tools for clinicians in combating cancer. So welcome, Stephen. It's a pleasure meeting you.
Thank you very much. Thank you for having me. Good to meet you too.
Prescient Therapeutics Limited is working into the exciting area of cancer research. Can you give a brief background of the company and what does Prescient stand for, as well as what gives it an edge over its competitors?
Yeah, sure. So we're about personalising cancer treatment to drive better outcomes for those patients. And we do it in two ways. One with targeted therapies, and that is seeking to switch off the very specific drivers of that tumour, the genetic drivers of that tumour that cause it to replicate. And the other way we're doing it is with this new field called cell therapies, which is looking to enhance a patient's immune cells. This is creating living medicines, living cells that attack the cancer. And we have very unique technologies that no one has in this personalized approach.
Thank you for your insights. Now, CAR T cell therapy is an emerging space in Australia with only a handful of players active in this area. How is Prescient positioned in this market?
Pleasingly, we're well ahead of the curve, and not just in Australia, but globally. And just stepping back a little bit, what CAR T is, for those who aren't aware, is a way of taking a patient's own immune cells. This is a cancer patient. You take their blood and isolate the immune cells that are responsible for fighting infection. And instead of fighting infection, they are reprogrammed outside of the body to recognize and attack cancer. And that is a CAR T cell, and they're grown up and injected back into the patient. So the patient's getting a turbocharged version of their own immune cells. And whilst this is a genuine revolution in the history of human medicine, because we've never seen responses like we have with this therapy, what I'd like to emphasize, it is just the start. So as we've seen with any new technology, the first iteration is revolutionary, but it's also just the beginning, sort of like where VHS tapes were, or in, like the iPhone 1. That's currently where CAR T is at. And what Prescient is about is developing next generation technologies in this rapidly evolving field that address the big problems: safety, control, flexibility, all which are, you know, still key problems with current generation technologies. And we are seeking to address those and create next generation versions that's going to take these VHS tapes and take them to Netflix. That's what we're about.
Great, thanks for sharing that. And Prescient recently expanded its relationship with Peter Mac. How is the company progressing with the OmniCAR program development?
Yeah, so this is the next generation CAR T programs. It's going very, very well. We've now got soon to be two postdocs currently, researchers full-time with Prescient and two full-time research assistants. This is all headed by our new Director of Scientific Affairs and cell therapy expert, Dr. Rebecca Lim. Lim is driving this with urgency and deep expertise. So we've designed and sourced and currently manufacturing all the components, the cells, the binders. Team at Peter Mac and headed by Rebecca is currently doing all the preparatory work necessary for this ambitious work program, so that they'll come together very, very shortly. And bottom line is we're on or ahead of schedule there. So working at a frantic pace.
And can you throw some light on the PDMAC agreement focusing on cell therapy enhancement programs? And if possible, can you also share any insights on the outcomes of the study so far?
I wish I could. This program is currently in stealth mode. So for those that don't know, so we've got Omnicar, which is next generation CAR T. And what the cell therapy enhancement program is in stealth mode is looking to enhance current generation CAR Ts. But at the same time, it's also going to be relevant at enhancing next generation CAR T programs as well. And early signs are very encouraging on this, and we're really looking forward to sharing more as the data unfolds and we exit stealth mode.
Well, we'll definitely be watching the space to find out more. And moving on to the targeted therapies, by when can we see the PTX100 and PTX200 moving to the phase two studies?
Yeah, with PTX100, that's all on track to conclude very shortly, and we are hoping to report on our top line safety results for the phase 1b basket study very, very soon. And that will also give us an indication of next steps for that program as we head towards phase 2, or hopefully, fingers crossed, even a registrational study. So the results on that are imminent. With PTX200, the AML study is underway. We just announced recently some progress on that, escalating to the next cohort at 45 milligrams per meter squared in a terrible type of blood cancer called acute myeloid leukemia. And we're hoping that will that's on track to conclude later this year as well. And we are also exploring a new exciting indication for that drug as well, which we haven't communicated with the market yet, but look forward to doing so soon.
Hopefully any economic delays, such as the ones caused by the COVID-19 pandemic in the last 12 months, will not delay the results any further. Could you highlight the near-term vision and goals of Prescient Therapeutics? And also, where would the management like to see the company in the next 1 to 2 years, please?
Yes, so it's a good question. Importantly, I think of Prescient in terms of three different buckets, if you like, of activity. One is with advancing our targeted therapies, which are in the clinic, PTX 100 and 200. We've got our cell therapy enhancements currently coming out of stealth mode, hopefully, and then Omnicar, which is the next generation CAR T programs. And we're advancing three really innovative and highly differentiated next generation CAR T programs. And within that time frame, we actually hope to be in the clinic in at least two of those three programs, which is incredibly ambitious and will be a remarkable and significant achievement for the company. I think the take home message here is that unlike some companies who have a single program or only in clinical mode, where you're in a black box of news flow for the next period of time, a year or two, we've got a nice diverse pipeline of early news, mid news, and late stage news in terms of clinical development. So there'll be lots of opportunity for value creation and engagement with the market.
Is Prescient exploring additional collaboration and licensing opportunities to advance CAR T development at all?
We are always, we're conducting our three programs in-house independently of anyone else. So we stand on our own two feet there, and we're not dependent on other people to progress those. That's a great position to be in. But absolutely, this is an enabling platform that can be like the computer chip inside other people's computers. So anyone else in CAR T, anyone else in even antibody development, we've got a dog in that fight now with Omnicar. So absolutely, we are always looking for those opportunities. But you have to play the long game with these parties. They are very conservative and they want to take time to be familiar with the science and track the progress of the programs. But we are doing absolutely all the things that we should be doing, which is constant interactions with these people so that they can see it unfold and build familiarity and confidence, which is happening pleasingly. To that end, we have a full-time VP of Business Development Alliances, Dr. Dan Shelley, and he's based in the US and is full-time on business development to cover this. And that's especially important in the COVID era where there's less travel. It's great to have someone on the ground in the biggest market in the world.
And I wish we had more time, as this is such an important project that you are developing further. But we have to wind up now. Are there any final thoughts you would like to share with our esteemed audience here at Calkine?
Yeah, just in summary, I think it's a great time to be involved in Prescient, ASX code PTX. Bottom line is we've got lots of shots on goal. We're not a one-trick pony. We have a simple model. We source our technology from the best and we work with the best. So we've got technology underlying our programs from Yale University, Moffitt Cancer Center, Oxford University, University of Pennsylvania, it's another Ivy League uni. We're well funded, we have a great team and world-class collaborators. And most importantly, we are actually genuinely at the forefront of this incredible wave. And we have many catalysts, both in the short term and the medium term, for value creation.
And that was a fabulous show. It was lovely chatting with you, Stephen, and thank you again for your time. With that, iSage will sign off for today and watch this space for more. Until then, as we say, stay apprised and invest wise with Calkine.